So, as you heard, the toolkit of active filter and spirit cancellation multiple functions. Now we're going to focus on a specific kind of multiple function, which is Dirichlet characters. But friends apply a bit more generally than that, so if people are interested in that, they can ask later. And so the plan of the talk, so first of all, there'll be an introduction. And I'll talk about spirit cancellation a bit and state some results. And the results will be of two kinds, so they'll be results in a sort of random number problem. So how does a different multiple function behave? And so in the second part, we're going to say something about the ideas of a proof in a random case. And then it turns out you can use the results in a random case to deduce things in some deterministic settings as well. So the third part of the talk is going to be focus a little bit about proof ideas in the deterministic case. So I have to check at this point, is that visible at the back? So let's start with a very straightforward problem, hopefully. So, the letter R will be a large prime, because P and Q will be used to other things later. And X, somewhere between 1 and strictly less than R, let's say. And then I want to look at the sum of the Dirichlet character chi, all of the relevance to X and R, square this, and add one character. So the sum of all characters chi by R, and R is prime, so there are R minus 1, of course. And I want to know how big this is. Of course, we can do that. So I can expand n squared, so this is the sum over n1 and 2 plus x, and then I'll move this up to the inside. Sum of pi, pi of n1, pi of n2, conjugate. And I'm going to reality, the only term is pi, the only term is n1 is smaller than n2, or r. And since everything is smaller than r, the only term that happens is n1 and n2 actually the same. So the only term is smaller than diagonal term, so this is just the smaller these two terms. Okay, so I hope this is uncontroversial so far. Right, so I'll make two remarks about this. So first of all, we'll have the principal character in the sum. I needed that to get the perfect orthogonality. But unless x is really big, it doesn't matter really whether the principal character is there or not. So provided x is smaller than, let's say, 0.99 or minus 1, the principal character it's 4x squared, but there's only one principal character, so we divide by r minus 1. And under this condition, this is at most 0.99 4x. Okay, so I can remove 0.99 4x from 4x and not change the order of magnitude of the answer. So the most important thing to say, you can put the principal character in or take it out if you want, it'll make a difference. And the other thing is, I'm going to remove that star. So star is consistent. So I'm going to do that.
distribution. This is what the spine has distribution. Some points.
window. In this setting, there's a good car. Hilton.
Is correct. It is a little bit of square attacks. It's actually
so that's all our time. And the XP buttons are 4. We're set to L. Minimum of X and R X. Bring E.
はい、75円100円をいただきます。25円の返しありがとうございます。
手続いて。